The murder led to the arrest and conviction of one William Stobie, a former member of the Ulster Defence Association, UDA, who, it emerged, had been recruited as an agent of Special Branch in 1987 and then re-infiltrated this loyalist terror group. In 2001, Stobie himself was shot dead by his former UDA comrades. A series of inquiries by Sir John Stevens, later Commissioner of the Metropolitan Police, found that there had been widespread collusion between the RUC, the Army, and Loyalist terrorists in the murder of Irish nationalists. Stevens also reported that he had been obstructed in his work throughout by elements within the RUC and the Army. A further report, this one by Sir Desmond de Silva, and commissioned by the Coalition Government in 2012, upheld all the findings of the Stevens reports and concluded that there had been a complete lack of coordination between the various agencies charged with providing security in Northern Ireland from the mid-1980s. It was acknowledged that many members of the RUC and the Army had been killed or maimed during the Troubles, but also that individuals and groups within those services had taken matters into their own hands by way of vengeance and had resented the controls that were put on them by their superiors. Clearly, the events described above post-date Oldfield's time in Northern Ireland, and I make no claim that things would necessarily have been different or better had he stayed in his post. But these reports, which cover the past 30 years in some shocking detail, lay bare the complexity of the situation in the province. Stevens and De Silva demonstrate vividly, and with a tangible sense of dismay, the tensions that existed between and within the various security services, and how individuals weren't beyond taking enormous liberties with their positions, to the point of colluding in murder. His time in Northern Ireland was, without question, the saddest and loneliest of Morris's life.